You are either studying or thinking about becoming an ML engineer or data scientist or software engineer. And I am almost sure you came across a video like Day in the Life of a Data Scientist, the Day in the Life of a Machine Learning Engineer, or something along those lines. And most of those videos go something like this. Eating, developing, meeting, fancy coffee place, eating beers, maybe developing again, and yeah, maybe some fancy gym. And I mean, yes, that is the life sometimes, and it can kind of be very rarely. Now, what I want to do with this video is show you what a professional ML engineer actually does, and not what our bar looks like. It's cool, it has a lot of plans for some reason, but yeah, getting back on track. What all these videos have in common is this: they are all taking place behind a desk. Inside, at a computer, and this is what you really should understand when taking really any career path involving programming. You will be sitting behind your computer for at least 6 hours per day. You can steer how many meetings you want to have or not, but more often than not, they will also be in some Teams call well inside. If this is not you, reconsider your life choices, maybe around right now. And this is what we are going to try to do in this video, looking into some not so positive sides of being a machine learning engineer and for that fact also data scientist, more often than not. What you will be doing for most of your time and not just the highlights. Yes, as many other videos will be showing, there will be conferences, hackathons, sport, fancy coffee places and all those fun activities we all like. But the main reason those other creators will show you that is that they want you to watch their entire video, and that is just a lot easier to do when showing those really cool activities with a story on a special day with a lot of interaction and not those maybe somewhat solo activities that will dominate your actual work life. I am talking about this because I think many of these videos are somewhat misleading, and today we want to be slightly more honest. So what does an actual day in the life of a machine learning engineer actually look like? Obviously, this will be different from industry to industry, from team to team and person to person, but almost all of them follow roughly this pattern. You have stand up every day, usually around morning. This is where you get together with your team and let them know what you did yesterday and what you are planning on doing today. Potentially you talk about problems you're facing. I have seen here different levels of interaction, and it can depend heavily on how many people are actually working on the same project or product in the team at any given time. But it can go from 5 minutes to 30 minutes, usually depending on the collective interest level in each other's stories and how important to them it is what you're doing right now. Now, after this, often people have some additional things to discuss, which rarely requires the entire team. Usually, this is about one person helping another person. As a machine learning engineer, you will be responsible for the infrastructure, and often you will help someone with problems they have with that, or discuss one of your problems or design decisions with someone also working on that infrastructure or the project you are working on. But this can really depend on the structure of your team. Some teams are 5 times the same type of job, and some are more cross-functional, where you will typically be one of the more technical people compared with the data analyst and the data scientist, which will have a bit more to do with business knowledge and data details. After the stand-up, your days will be either all meetings or all coding, in my experience, with the occasional support case running around. You will have meetings on various projects and discussions with stakeholders where they either ask you why your model is doing something different than they expect, or you ask them why this strange thing in their data is different than you expect. Seems to be a common topic. Someone doesn't understand something. Also, discussing what projects might be become a reality and how you can help and plan to make them a reality will play a big role in this. As a machine learning engineer, you will also be involved in some more technical discussions about what usually is consider machine learning, things like, you know, APIs, computing clusters, different storage technologies, and who should have access to what, or even data protection. This is also the part where I would say, if you are not too much into software engineering in any way, maybe consider going a bit more in the direction of a data scientist. But really, these job titles can mean anything, and it really varies a lot from company to company. Maybe as a word of advice, if you're interviewing with a company, ask them what different data roles they have. If they answer data analyst, data scientist, data engineer, machine learning engineer, MLOps engineer, business analyst, data architect, and maybe 5 more roles that sound almost made up, you know what level of variation you can expect during your time there. I'm not saying that having more of these titles is better. In the end, it depends on what you enjoy doing in life. I personally feel that my almost 50% machine learning project work, 20% infrastructure work, 10% support, and 20% meetings are a great fit for my personal life. But if you prefer something else, you can definitely find the right position for you somewhere. These numbers can fluctuate a lot depending on if you just started or if you are migrating some legacy code base or if a project is in a particular stage. If you, for example, just deployed an ML model, you will often just implement monitoring in your job. Often looks more like a data analyst jobs really for a bit. Now there are a lot more stages to ML project, and that is maybe a topic for another video. If you are interested in that, subscribe and let me know. We could finish the job right here. However, I feel like sharing some additional things about this job that are at least at first surprised me. Number one would be you will have a lot to work on someone else's task. While this seems very logical, it implies a lot that you might not be aware of right now. Depending on the company or position you will be joining, you will basically work on the same type of ML problem for a long time. This can be either natural language processing, image recognition, some time series forecasting in a niche domain, or whatever. Some companies will always only have one feasible type of data and proper use case. If you're working on a weather forecasting service, well, you will be forecasting the weather. If you're working for a lending service, you will mostly evaluate the creditworthiness of lenders and so on. Bigger companies will have a large range of these tasks, but still you will find that now that you are the expert on, let's say, image data, you will also take over the next image data project, and yeah, this defines a lot of your time. But you will also be working on someone else's code base, or you can also consider it a commonest thing if you are into that, like it is your team's code base or whatever, but it eventually leads to you mostly settling for one cloud, one programming language, one monitoring tool, and one and so on. It's usually not one and more like one and a half, but what I'm trying to say is you will not start doing something completely different on your next project. Depending on what multiprocessing framework is hot and fashionable right now. Honestly, you will probably work on the same Python version for 2 years and wait until TensorFlow and all your favorite libraries will also support that one version. Another part of work I was generally surprised by is the amount of documentation, and I even can say that my current company is taking it pretty light when it comes to that. Documenting the results of your work, and when I say documenting, I don't really think documentation in your code, I mean writing pages on Confluence. That's like an internal company Wikipedia for those that don't know it. I mean writing emails and Teams messages. I mean writing stories and commenting why it can't progress or doesn't make sense anymore in Jira. To some of you, especially when coming from other jobs, this is probably not big news, but it really takes me at least 30 minutes a day to write some new manual, a few stories, or move some graphics with description over to Confluence. And if you have done 10 days of exploratory data analysis for projects and see if it is feasible with this data or something of that sort, you can easily take another 2 days to write that down in a presentable format or taking meeting notes and all these little aspects. To close this, I would like to end with the most striking realization. When you are coming from, let's say, an academically clean data world with strong signals to the real messy data world, you will realize that you have now all the data and it is mostly noise and a lot of garbage. There will be users clicking buttons that only make sense to be clicked once for some reason 20 times per minute and somehow another 5 hours later. Or somehow the data from some week is missing or manipulated by someone in the company, probably for a good reason. Now you run around and clean all of this and try to understand why it happened. What I'm trying to say is that you will be cleaning data a lot. And no matter what you do, it is almost never clean for a long period of time. Because the company around the data that is collected, your company changes constantly. But even if you have a sub problem that has all these problems removed somehow, you start measuring what you hypothesized must have a clear correlation, and somehow there really is just noise. Like, yes, you can cheat yourself, and given your advanced statistical knowledge, you can fake it for so long that you start believing it yourself. But really, it is mostly noise, and therefore a lot you will do in your daily life with data of any sort will just not work. And quite honestly, I talked with a lot of data scientists and machine learning engineers that were all working for big market leaders in their respective companies. And even though you theoretically have all the data, it somehow, for various reasons, doesn't have any signal you can use properly to establish a clear solution for a problem. Where am I getting at with this? Many problems and projects you will start will not have a great outcome, or will not go productive or work in the form you hoped for in the first year or so. Given that the video is already pretty long, I think we will close it for today with that. Once again, thank you for tuning in, and even though this video may give you a negative impression all in all, it is still one of the best jobs in the world, and I think you will love it as well. But nothing is perfect, and I think people should stop pretending that the world of data is.